connection between God and his people is at breaking point.
You worship foreign idols! You defile your God!
Everything the Israelites have fought for is under threat. Jerusalem's survival depends on a weak new leader. The city is doomed if King Zedekiah doesn't return to God. Jerusalem's 21st king, Zedekiah, is caught between the region's superpowers. He is conspiring with Egypt, but owes allegiance to Babylon. News of his betrayal has reached the Babylonian king, Nebuchadnezzar. Since the time of David, prophets like Jeremiah have guided their kings. They are Israel's direct link with God. But Jeremiah's warnings have gone unheeded. Now he delivers a final message to Zedekiah. Surrender to Nebuchadnezzar, or die.
That.
This is you. If you are wise, place yourself under the yoke of Babylon. Accept the Lord's retribution and know that he is being lenient with you. These are God's words. Submit to King Nebuchadnezzar. Bow your head. You dare tell your king to bow down? How dare you question a prophet of God? It's you who offends. It's you who must change.
Remove him, traitor.
Come on!
city sealed.
Yes, my king.
No one escapes.
After 18 months, the trapped Israelites start to starve. The desperate resort to cannibalism.
Need.
Nothing has changed. All Jerusalem will burn.
You but repent, repent, and all will be well. God will save us.
Look out there. You're too late.
Strike hard. Strike hard and victory will be ours. And whatever's left of Jerusalem. Help yourself.
Jerusalem is destroyed. Zedekiah and his sons escape through a secret passageway.
Then he must be brave for me.
His people are not so lucky.
No! Jerusalem! Jerusalem is ours. Jerusalem is ours. Punish them for trying to resist me. Make them pay. Temple to the ground. Everything we fought for is lost.
Since the time of Abraham, the Jewish people have struggled for this promised land. Now the hopes and dreams of generations are destroyed. Nebuchadnezzar's Babylonian army ransacks Jerusalem. The Jewish people flee for their lives. Among them, a young nobleman called Daniel.
This way, Daniel!
Help us, Lord! It's locked!
Daniel, get behind me!
They look valuable. Take them alive.
Azariah!
Daniel! Daniel!
Azariah!
No!
We're people of God!
Daniel!
Stay together! Azariah!
Find Zedekiah. Find his family.
Yes, sir.
There's a price for betrayal.
Safe now.
You're done!
into exile. A 500-mile journey east to Babylon. Jeremiah is one of the few to escape. He heads to Egypt, never to return. Needs a different kind of leader to survive in Babylon. A man like Daniel. Daniel has visionary powers and is forced to work in Nebuchadnezzar's court.
Has no one anything to tell me? Can you not even describe my dream?
Silence is no answer.
Supposed to be wise men, sorcerers, seers.
So what do you see?
Sire, forgive me. No one here can read your mind.
Then what evil surely of you?
My God can. He has shown me your dream.
Then you will be able to tell it to me. Every detail.
You saw a giant statue of a man. Its head made of gold. Then a giant stone struck the statue, smashing it to pieces.
I know that much.
What does it mean?
The statue represents the empires that will follow yours. Yours is the greatest. The head of gold.
And the stone that destroys the statue.
That is the kingdom of God. In the future, God will reign over all the world. Forever.
Destroyed by God.
Yes, sire.
What's your name?
Daniel.
You're a brave man, Daniel. I value that. You will serve me.
Will we ever return to Jerusalem? Jeremiah promised that one day we would.
In the meantime, what do we do? Just bow our heads and serve this monster? I can't do it anymore.
Think about our people, Azariah.
As long as we're in the King's Court, we can help them, imprisoned or dead, we can't.
Nebuchadnezzar destroyed God's temple, forced us into exile. My name is Azariah, he who is helped by God. I call upon God to help me now.
Don't do this, he'll kill you.
I will not worship that.
Hearts, we follow you.
Bow your heads!
And seek your presence.
With all my heart, I follow you. I fear you. I seek your presence.
Bring them!
Oh, my friends. Your faith will be tested now.
Daniel! What's wrong with them? Why will your friends not bow to me?
I assure you, sire, they will serve you faithfully, all their lives, as I will, but...
But?
But they will only worship God.
I will make them bow.
Seek your presence.
You.
When we wish to bend something that is hard and unyielding, what do we do with it? We put it into the fire.
Majesty, take him!
Hear you! And we seek your presence!
Burn them! Majesty, no! Burn them! What? No! Hey, bring oil! Come! Please come! Fire! Bring me fire!
Hear my cry. The cords of death entangle me. The anguish of the grave consumes me. Do not ignore my tears. I am overcome by sorrow. I call upon the name of the Lord! Lord, save me!
Why do they not burn?
against the Jewish people. Far from allowing their faith to weaken in exile, they reaffirm their trust in God. The laws and histories that Moses received on Mount Sinai are preserved and compiled with the books of Joshua, Samuel, and Kings. Together, they form the heart of the Hebrew Bible. The Jewish people have their faith, but they're still prisoners. The only man who can set them free has lost his mind.
Greatest king and lowliest man on God's earth. See, where your pride has brought you and us. You could have set us free. Now we are as trapped as you.
Nebuchadnezzar's death, a massive army approaches Babylon, led by Cyrus, king of Persia.
Let them know we've arrived.
The Babylonians know they don't stand a chance. They let Cyrus in without a fight.
Set us free if the prophecy is right.
To protect his fellow Jews, Daniel befriends Cyrus and continues to interpret dreams.
What does your dream mean, Daniel?
It's not my dream, sire.
There's a prophet here in Babylon, Isaiah. He says,
"Here's a king whose right hand I take hold of to subdue nations before him. He is Cyrus. He names you, sire. It means God is with you."
I think you flatter me. But no one has ever died of flattery.
Your Majesty has done many great things, as the record will show. As it should.
He has lost the power to think for himself.
Daniel must be removed. One month without prayer. Surely only a traitor would object.
I cannot go back on my word. I promised them freedom to worship.
It is merely a test of their loyalty. They have had so many rulers. We wanted to make sure they saw you as the final, ultimate king of the world. One month without prayer. It probably sounds reasonable to Cyrus, but they know we can't comply.
They don't care about the king. They just want as much power over him as they can get.
Which means they need you out of their way. It's a trap for all of us. They want us dead.
A whole month. What will you do?
I don't know. But I do know I can't live long without praying to God.
Save me, O God, by your name. Have mercy on me. According to your unfailing love. Create in me a pure heart, O God. And renew a steadfast spirit within me. Do not cast me from your presence or take your Holy Spirit from me. But restore to me the joy of your salvation, and grant me a willing spirit to sustain me.
disobeying Cyrus, Daniel is arrested and sentenced to death.
Are you unwell?
I haven't slept. Please God, I'm not too late.
Sire, shall I call the physician?
I have wronged my friend!
Open it.
God is with you. Your God is real. Your God has saved you.
Yes.
I am Cyrus, king of the world, and my judgment is this. Your people shall return to Jerusalem.
Their God will be pleased. Though, sadly, they no longer have a temple to worship him in.
Thank you.
temple in Jerusalem. It's beautiful. You know, I've never seen it used. And staying here in Babylon, I suppose now I never will.
But our children will, when they get to Jerusalem, when the temple is rebuilt and our nation is restored. Our struggle is over.
There's something I need to show you. Come on. Unimaginably strong. It had great iron teeth, and it devoured the whole world. But God will not abandon us. I saw a great new leader. In my dream, there before me was one like a son of man, coming with the clouds of heaven. He was given authority, glory, and sovereign power. Nations and men of every language worshipped him. This isn't the end, Azariah. It's the beginning.
The Jewish people will need help to survive what is coming. Over the next 500 years, their tiny nation is attacked again and again. Then they succumb to the might of Rome.